Sanjiv Bhasin is now joining us. Sanjiv, good afternoon. Thank you so much for taking out time for us. What do you think is happening in the markets for the last 2 days? Have the markets discounted at 25 basis points? After that, everybody was expecting a risk on rally, and probably shorts are getting scared, and that's why covering is coming in the last couple of days.
Yeah, hi, Pankaj. Well, it's a very smart rally we've had, and I think it's a precursor to the next few days. Globally, there was too much of fear on this Fed tightening, and the repercussions are more severe on the high yield debt in the US and globally, where we've seen that liquidity concerns have actually made people sell in most of the emerging markets and currencies, or, to take that risk off. So I think we tended to get oversold, and now when the dawn has come that it won't be as bad for equities as is being made out, I think the markets have started to rally, and you've seen a lot of short covering. We think that this was a beautiful opportunity to buy, because there was fear for unfounded reasons. You know, we were falling because of our own reasons of poor results and, not as much deliverance on the reforms and macros being, stable. But I think the foreign selling was more accentuated because of those liquidity concerns. So we think it was a brilliant opportunity to buy, and we think we are headed to maybe 8,100 in the next fortnight. And we've been recommending to buy around this 75 to 7,700 on the Nifty.
Right. Say if Fed delivers exactly what is estimated, and even the tone seems to be dovish, or again what the street is estimating, do you think the markets will make a near-term bottom, at least till the time we have any next major negative surprise coming in, markets would have made a bottom?
Yes, Pankaj, I'll tell you the first anecdote on the domestic markets, which simplifies this fear being priced in, is the VIX index. In August, September, when we had a brutal sell-off because of this and other concerns, the VIX went all the way up to 30, 27, 28, 30 was the high. This time, even though the markets have corrected, the VIX didn't go over 18, which is telling you that the event of 25 basis point is already priced in. There is no going back on that. On the other hand, like I said, the escalation is more on the high yield debt bonds over there, which has seen this type of cascading effect in global markets and maybe Nifty because of that. So we see this 7500 has held out as a very, very strong bottom. We don't see that getting replicated. And on the upside, we think there will be a lot of short covering, because globally people are short on equities. And secondly, we'll see a lot of value buying emerge after the event gets over, because there is always the fear of the event. And I think once that takes place tonight, tomorrow morning, we should be up and running.
Right. Markets have been talking about this hike since the end of 2013. So it's been almost about 2 years that markets have been trying to price in this particular event. Say if it happens today, it's an enough talked about, enough researched about event that markets are fully prepared for this hike. I mean, 2 years down the line also, there is still that uncertainty going into that rate hike.
Well, easy money will, and its withdrawal is like a drug. You've been living on that easy money for 7-8 years, and now any small withdrawal will cause its little bit of a repercussion. But I think it is all. I think the markets have in fact overdone the selling because of in anticipation. It's already priced in, Pankaj. I think tomorrow, in fact, she might sound a little bit more dovish and signal that at least for the next. In 2016, at least for the next 4 to 6 months, there may be nothing of another hike coming in the way. It will only come when data strengthens and the markets are strong enough to respond. So I think, like I said, like you've said, it's been 2 years coming, and the sooner it gets over is better. Last time people expected it to come in October, and it's not coming. Actually, saw the market sell off. So I think it's a win-win situation. Globally, bond yields everywhere have adjusted to that. There was just that section of the market which had high yield, which was on high yield debt, and that saw liquidity concern. But I think a lot of that is also got addressed. So we think everything is status quo after this, and we think the markets will start to resume their uptick, given that data has been strengthening in the US and in Europe. And locally also, we are seeing a lot of green shoots appear on the Indian economy.
But you think over a period of time, or say going into 2016 or by the second half of 2016, people would have forgotten this event and focus would shift back to corporate performance and earnings?
Pankaj, we'll forget it in a week. I don't think you'll look for 6 months. It's already priced in. The US 10-year bond has already rallied and come back to plateau. So I don't think there will be too much of a noise. You know, it's like the RBI. Once it comes in for 3 days, you'll have an effect on both sides of the market after it gets priced in. So like I said, it's going to be more her language on the signal of when the next hike is going to be there on the cards. And I don't think that is coming in the first half of 2016.
Right. How would you look at valuations at 77, 77.50? Do you think that valuations are good enough to attract a lot of funds, say if there is a liquidity crunch as well?
Well, you know, it's a divided field. I think at 7,700, maybe the Nifty would be at fair value. But, you know, there are a lot of stocks and sectors which are giving opportunities. Say the PSU, say the private sector banks, some of them have taken it on the chin purely because they were overowned by FIs. And also the bank Nifty, you know, Pankaj, it's corrected more than the Nifty. We think there is a lot of value accretion there. Like we said, there are a whole host of sectors, you know, stocks like L&T, Coal India. I can go on naming stocks, TCS on that decline to 23, 30, 40. There is a basket of stocks which are there to be bought. It's just that the number deliverance may take another quarter or so. We should actually see some sort of a better environment coming in the January quarterly numbers. And I think the rupee has also responded very well in a basket of currencies. The RBI has defended 67, and we see no reason for overshooting that in the next fortnight. So I think given the extent of the sell-off and opportunities, there are enough amount of stocks which can make money in the near future.
Right. You know, the point that you made about earnings, you think earnings recovery would start from quarter three? That's the numbers that we start getting in the next 25, 30 days?
Well, you know, this Chennai floods will have dampened some issues on auto and IT, and you've already heard the warnings. But I think a lot of negative has been already priced into banks, and I would expect a positive surprise on the upside, given that asset quality overall has tended to improve, and I think net interest margins should expand slightly on the upside. Already we've seen State Bank, Yes Bank and a couple of other numbers on advanced tax coming way ahead of what the street was expecting. So I think that pessimism may play out on the positive side. And I think the broader market would tend to outperform given that we've had low interest costs, low commodity prices. And that would definitely help in margin accretion for a lot of sectors.
Right. Going into 2016, this year has been about mid-cap. That's 2015. You think now large caps also have a lot of value? Large caps can also outperform in 2016 versus the mid-cap?
Well, Pankaj, like we said, this is a market which is played month on month. And right now, you are right. For the next few months, we would be very, very bullish on the large cap stocks, given the extent of nearness in price earnings, which has come on the mid-cap and large cap. It's never happened in many years that I've been tracking. That is what gives me a lot of comfort on some of the, you know, large cap blue chips. And that is where we are ready to put our money. So we are recommending only large caps where we think there is safety on the downside. There is visibility on the future. And numbers should surprise maybe on the upside.
Right, Sanjiv. Just a last word, as far as rupee and the strength over there is concerned, how would it impact the FII flows? You think it's not getting in cheaper for them versus some of the other emerging markets just purely because of currency?
Yeah, so, you know, it's been allied well. You know, 67 has been defended. We think over a period of time, maybe if there is another crisis, you could even touch levels of 68. But we still think this band of 65, 66 and a half is where the RBI is very comfortable. So the puppets are playing in the hands of the RBI governor, and he's laughing his way to the bank, because when it comes lower, he's a buyer. When it goes towards 67, he's a seller. I think it gives a lot of comfort to the FIs. On the other hand, this sort of selling which we saw also has been very well absorbed by the domestic institutions, which only reinstates that there is now more depth in the Indian market than you imagined. And, you know, aside from the large cap, small mid cap valuation, I think going ahead, this type of an event or an impact cost has been dealt very swiftly, because you've had huge amount, almost $2 billion worth of outflows in the last few months. And even though the market's corrected 3-4%, they have absorbed all that. So it's telling you that now when that buying may emerge in 2016, you also will have a sweet side on the upside, because FIs are going to be, you know, more driven by macros globally than by local events.
Sanjiv, you were talking about IT companies. You think in Q3, IT companies would really have a big impact, and we can see the impact much more than what so far has been guided. It is quite possible that we may see huge downgrades coming in.
Well, you know, you'll have to discount what the language is it, because most people will discount that it was just this one quarter because of the Chennai flood, and what's the outlook for the global environment going forward. I don't think there should be much downside, because the US and Europe have started to show a lot of traction on the upside. I think it should be status quo, maybe with a guidance on the upside being revived by Infosys, Wipro and TCS. So we have a buy on these three stocks, but the real money is in the mid-cap IT, where we've been very, very bullish, and we continue to chase names like Tata Elxsi, Mindtree and NIT Technologies.
Do you think that e-commerce companies, as soon as they start coming with their IPOs in 2016, will be a big threat to valuations of these companies? Because right now people don't have option, but once they start to get option, they'll start removing money from these companies, and they have big money into you know, some of the large cap IT names.
Well, I don't think. I think any good issue, if it's worth its worth its while, and you think there is money to be made, then only. Firstly, I think the valuations of some of the e-commerce is absurd, and I think it may be a bubble if you come in those valuations. So there will be sane people who will know what to sell and what to buy. And the money is not an issue, Pankaj. Whenever the right time comes, people don't sell their gold to buy, the other asset. I think it will be met with more trepidation than exuberance. So for us, I don't think there is that call for a sectoral rotation. New money will be able to be finding its roots if there is justification in the pricing of that whole e-commerce basket.
Right. What do you make of the oil stocks today? Names like IGL, that is Indra Plus Gas, Gujarat Gas, GAIL, all of them are buzzing in. You think that Delhi pollution, the control over there, shifting towards CNG, which is the focus, will benefit these companies?
Well, that's what the speculation is, that, and this, I think, is a serious measure with the Supreme Court coming out with observations. So it tells us that some of the, that old monopoly of the diesel lobby may be on its way down, and you'll have to adjust yourself to new vehicles. And it opens the playground for a lot of the CNG components. So rightly, maybe there is, maybe in the short run, there is speculation on the pullback, and maybe the stocks are outdoing themselves on the upside. But definitely there will be justification for earnings upgrade if it actually materializes the way the Supreme Court and the local governments are making such a big issue. And rightly so. I think it's about time the diesel monopoly came back to earth. They've been flying in the air too long. And you'll have an equal playing field for a number of other company stocks where there'll be money to be made on the upside.
Right. Names like M&M, clear avoid right now?
Clear avoid, sell on any rally. This whole... Tech Mahindra should be downgraded if you own it, because this Pininfarina has been a loss-making company. All you're doing is you're trying to spread your eggs globally. But, you know, you have to see the assets you're buying. And locally, I think there will be a lot of pressure. And, their bread and butter is coming from most of the diesel segment. So for us, any rise should be an opportunity to sell both those stocks, Tech Mahindra and Mahindra.
Right. Paper of Defense is up 18-19% today. The open offer that Reliance Infra had given got closed yesterday. You think after that it is adjusting to what some of the ADAG names have done of late?
Well, it could be a one-off. The ADAG stocks have started to show a lot of traction on the upside, mainly because the promoter has now finally realized that he has to get rid of debt. So his first action of getting out of Arcom was welcomed by the market. Secondly, he's also indicated a lot of his non-core assets will be on the block. And as and when cash returns, I think there will be a lot of room on the upside. However, I think this make in India is now spreading to every second corporate which wants that a pie in that, And I don't know how long that variable will work. So it's all in the realm of speculation, and as long as there is no hardcore news coming, you could continue to see some of these stock sectors outperform on the upside.
Right, but do you think defense names like Pipa or Shipyard, once they go into ADAG pack or, you know, a big corporate, investors which used to not look at it earlier will start to look at it now?
Well, you know, like I said, it's not some pedigree of, you know, some big name which is there. ADAG has always been shrouded by a lot of encumbrances when going into the, you know, most market people are very wary about that. But, you know, like I said, maybe it's a change of regime and he's raising cash. It could do well over there. However, we would like to recommend two stocks which are very, very sound footing and would be the biggest gainers of any of this Make in India on the defense side. One is L&T, and because of it has recently been beaten down excessively, we think at this 1250, 1300, it makes a very, very good buy. And the other is Bharat Forge. Even that has come down substantially after the recent downgrades and weakness which the earnings which the company has shared. But at these valuations, both these companies are very good proxy for anything on the Make in India and the defense revival which you are talking of.
Sanjiv, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Always a pleasure talking to you.